The Philippine National Police all set for the inaugurations of President-elect Ferdinand Marcos Jr. and Vice President-elect Sara Duterte Carpio. As part of PNP's heightened security preparations, its director for operations has requested for the temporary suspension of all permits to carry firearms. Thousands of police officers will be deployed to secure the separate programs of the two leaders. The PNP also reminds the public, demonstrations near the venue of Marcos Jr.'s inauguration in Manila are not allowed.
The world is watching us, and we do not allow unruly and unauthorized rally. No? Meron tayong tinatawag na mga freedom parks dito, meron tayong Liwasang Bonifacio and all the rest, where they could air their grievances and issues, not in areas where it is not authorized, especially by local government. Sa aming pagkikipag-ugnayan sa ating mga local government units na involved, sa ating pagkikipag-panayam sa kanila, ay wala pa po silang na-issue na permit to conduct rally force.
The Commission on Human Rights, meanwhile, warns authorities against illegally removing demonstration materials.
We are happy na may paglilinaw, napapayagan pa rin ang mga protesta o mga rally sa Freedom Park. We understand that pagdating sa public thoroughfares or public places, kinakailangan ng permit granted by the local government units under DPA 80. At kung hindi naman yun ibibigay, doon naman sa Freedom Park, hindi kailangan ng permit. Hindi tama o hindi legal, hindi wasto na alisin yung mga pagpapahayag in whatever form. Kasi sinasabi ng batas, as long as hinayag mo iyan ng maayos at hindi mo ito translate into a violent action, pinapayagan yan at guaranteed yan under the Constitution. Kumbaga, you are freely expressing your opinions. And it may be not negative or positive, but in a functioning democracy, napaka-importante na lahat ng diverse opinions ay naririnig.
Manila's incoming Public Works Chief says public-private partnerships will continue to play a role, if not a bigger one, in the Marcos administration's infrastructure program. Manny Bunoan says he saw how important PPPs were after having served as president of the San Miguel Corporation Tollways. Bunoan also on a mission to clean up the name of the DPWH, which has earned a reputation for being laden with corruption.
Gusto kong i-consolidate lahat ng mga kooperasyon na ating mga tao sa DPWH para mawala yung perception na yan at makapagbigay kami ng gustong yung inaasahan na trabaho at para maisulong natin yung infrastructure development program. Lalo na po ngayon sa panahon na ito na kailangan po natin na tulungan yung pag-unlad ng ating economy. Hindi lang po yung mga tao namin ang dapat i-professionalize, no? Pati yung construction industry po ay magtulong-tulong po kami. Pati doon sa mga contractors, kailangan din po maging professional din sila. At para yung pong quality naman ng infrastructure may bibigyan namin, na kagaya po yung ginagawa sa private sector, no? Na talagang puspusan na maganda.
The incoming administration should focus on strengthening the justice system to show that it means business in fighting corruption. That's according to Greco Belica, former chairman of the Presidential Anti-Corruption Commission. He adds, Marcos should also appoint people who are willing to combat corruption.
Corruption in government went severely or drastically down. Hindi po namin na zero yan dahil ang corruption, you know, in any government will never be zeroed because corruption really begins and ends with people. And as long as there are people, there will be corruption. Strengthen the justice system, put funds in the justice sector, and strengthen the offices like the Office of the Ombudsman, the courts, the PACG. If they start to do that, you know, and I believe na they are really serious about it. And I, and of course, if President-elect Bongbong Marcos will really be at the front line of this, then it will be a very strong campaign against corruption.
Senator Kiko Pangilinan busy transitioning to a private life after losing in the vice presidential race. But he says he will continue to advocate for farmers and fisher folk.
You know, we went around the country campaigning for food security and support for our farmers and our fisher folk. And regardless of the election results, food security is still critical. People will still need to eat, all the more now. Mataas ang patuloy na tumataas ang presyo ng bilihin, pataas ang presyo ng krudo, ng gasolina, napakasakit para sa ating mga farmers, kaya tuloy pa rin ang ating advokasya.
Pangilinan also urging the next administration to be tougher against agricultural smugglers.
The DA should be, and the BOC, the Customs, you know, and the DOF should be front and center in ensuring that there are no sacred cows in terms of bringing in all these imports. Pag walang sacred cows yan, habulin, bantayan yung pagpasok nitong mga smuggled na mga produkto. And you know, the impact on the agriculture sector of smuggled, unchecked products has led to the ASF, the African swine fever. Dahil imported na karne yan na hindi na-check, na kailangan talagang sampahan ng kaso, i-raid itong mga, under the Price Act, the DTI and the DA are empowered, you know, to go after hoarders, profiteers, and smugglers, obviously. So it's really enforcement.